Hello and assalamu alaikum. I am Afzal Badshah and this is the second part of the video about literature. And in this video we are going to discuss that how we will plan our research and how we are going to search the related studies. So when you start the literature searching, before that you confirm your topic, and according to the topic you design, you write your title. This may be an initial title, this is not a full title. You will change it according to the time and according to your search, according to your investigation. But at the first you write a dummy title. For example, my research proposal was, my PhD research proposal was about the revenue maximization in the cloud computing. And when you create such like title, this must have your goals. For example, I am working to maximize the revenue of the provider. And secondly, how you will achieve this goal. You have mentioned the second part, that how you are going to achieve this goal. For example, if I am going to maximize the provider revenue, but how I am going to maximize the revenue? What methodologies, what way I will use to maximize this the provider's revenue? So I propose that cloud provider revenue maximizations by efficient resources utilization. So by efficient resources utilization shows that this is the methodology, this is the way which I will use to maximize the provider's revenue. Exactly, you have to do the same. You have to write your own topic which will have your goals about which you are going to do, which you are going to achieve, and it will also have the target population. For example, this is, in my point of view, this is a cloud computing. It will cover the cloud computing business, and how this will be done. In my case, this will be done by efficient resources utilization. Okay, when you create your own title, according to this title you create your search string. If you haven't created the searching string and you are just writing optimizing or maximizing the provider revenue through customer satisfaction and efficient resources utilization, this will show you a thousands of results. And in these thousands of results, it will be hard for you to select a good results. So to select a good results and to filter the results into the all database, you create a search string. But how the search string is created? For example, in my case, you will create according to your case. What I will do, I will take the keywords. For example, in my case, the keywords are revenue is the one keyword, maximization is the second keyword, and cloud computing is also another keyword. And I can say that customer satisfaction is other keyword. Then you have to integrate these words with AND operator. Okay, for example, if I am going to search my own topic, how I will search them? I will write revenue and maximization and cloud computing and resources and utilization. Okay, this will pick up only the exact matching result. This will not waste your time and this will populate a very good results for you. So if you are going to search your topic, you have to use this search string to improve the results. After that, when you create your topic, when you write your title, and after the title you have created the search string which will help you in the database, you select the exact databases on the internet which you are going to use. In my case, I will use the IEEE, which is most cited, which is most popularly used website database for the cloud computing and electrical engineering. So for my case, that I will use the IEEE. So what is your case? According to that, you have selected any good database, and according to this string you select these databases to search the relative data and relative articles. And when you search these articles, these databases provide you the option that, are you searching the books, Are you searching the any general paper? Are you searching the conference paper? And it also give you options that according to the dates, that either you are searching from 2000, are you searching from 2010, are you searching from 2015. If you are going to search a recent literature, for example, I am going to search a literature for after the 2018, then I will select that I am searching the literature after 2018, and it will be only journal paper, because I am not going to cite any conference paper or any book. You can do that if you are going to search any good book, if you are going to search any conference paper, because sometimes conference paper give you a good idea than the journal paper. But if you are going to cite it in your paper, in your thesis, then I will suggest to use a good journal paper, because good journal papers have a good impact factors, their language is good and their methodology is good. And when you create a plan, for example, as I discussed with you, that you have such a paper, and I discussed this in the previous video too, that's how you plan. For example, you can create an Excel sheet, and in the Excel sheet there will be the first column, and in the first column you will write the year of the publication. For example, the search you have done, it is published in 2018, 2019, etc. After that, you should write the author's name in the second column. In the third, you should write the title of the paper. And after that, you should mention your parameters, your variables in the column. For example, I have taken some variables in my papers, in my literature for my doctoral degree, that one is customer satisfaction, the second is the resources utilization, the third is the cost minimization, because I am doing all these things to maximize the provider revenue. So you have write the parameters, you have you should write the variables which you have selected in the column. And if the paper is related to this column, you should write the relatedness in the same column. And also you should mention one another column too, where you should write the methodology, that what type of methodology they have utilized to get some type of result. And when you done that, at the end section of the in this column, you should write the summary, or before that you should write the limitations of the paper. And in the next column, you can write that what are the main achievement of this paper. When you write the main achievement and main limitation of this paper, this will help you during drafting your research literature section. There you will be able to easily write the achievement of this author, the achievement of this paper, and the limitation of this paper. This will not hurt you to rewrite it again. You will just copy it from there, because you have a long database in the Excel sheet. And after that, you should write the summary, as I suggested earlier, that it will be better to write two summaries. The first summary will be a few lines. You have to summarize all the paper in the few lines, because you are going to, if you are going to refer this paper not in the literature sections, then you will use these few lines to refer this paper. And if you are going to cite this paper, you are going to cite this in the literature, then you will definitely write a whole paragraph, and this paragraph should be well organized. And when you will write the summary here in the Excel sheet, you should use a well writing methods, you should use well academic writing methods to write there. You must have any header for this paragraph. After this, you have to explain the same header, and this header actually will be the achievement of this article, of this research. And after that, in the body, you should explain in detail that how they work and how they achieve this paper. And at the end, you must discuss the limitations, that what are the limitations of this paper. When you will do your research according to that way, and you will organize your research according to this Excel sheet, and you will search the paper according to the search thing as I suggested. This will help you much. This will help you not in this time. This may help you out after this paper. This will help in your thesis, and when you are writing some other paper, you may cite this paper easily there. And at the end, for example, you are doing MPhil, for example, you are doing PhD, you will have a lot of databases of the paper. You will read 70, 80 or more than 100 papers. And when you are going to write any other paper, you can easily search any method. You can search easily search any writer, or you can search easily any journal papers or related methodology papers or related variables paper. This will help you a lot. Meet you in the next video. Thank you.